Hello, welcome everybody. My name is Zsolt Hargitai. I work in the Hungarian Suse office. As an introduction, I'd like to talk some words about us and about Suse and why we are here and why we think OpenStack is important. Suse is a 25 years old company, and Suse was the first company which was created in the mind that we want to create open source solution for companies, so enterprise open source solutions. And the first one was, of course, Linux, Suse Linux Enterprise Server, and later we enlarged the portfolio and we work on many open source projects. And actually, Suse is part of a much bigger company called Microfocus. Microfocus is a large software company, and it contains many different brands, like Novell, NetIQ, Attachmate, Borland, all well-known brands also in Hungary, and these brands all belong to the Microfocus software group, and we here in Hungary represent the whole Microfocus software group. So if you have any questions regarding these softwares or these portfolios, we can answer these questions as well. And actually, just one remark to this, Microfocus recently bought the software part of Hewlett Packard Enterprise as well, so the whole software portfolio, including Data Protector, Service Desk, and all this software will belongs to us as well within half a year or something like that. So Microfocus will be one of the biggest software houses in the infrastructure software area. So that's about our mother company, and of course, today I like to talk to the open source part, which is Suse and containers and how to use containers in OpenStack. Why could we use containers in OpenStack? That would be the topic of today's presentation. We are in a big change in the business, in the computer industry. Many analysts says that we are in the fourth industrial revolution. The first one was the steam, the second one was the electricity, the third one is the internet. And now with all these different intelligent devices and robotics and artificial intelligence, we are just the beginning of the fourth industrial revolutions. And all the companies has to work with that, and we have to change, and we have to change the IT infrastructure as well to survive and to be successful in this new industrial revolution. So all the businesses need speed, agility, and competitive advantages over the other companies, and we have to create an IT infrastructure and business applications according to this. And all these technologies we are talking today, like cloud and like containers, help us all the companies to be agile and to be more competitive in this new area, in this new business area. And of course, if we are talking to cloud, we have to talk to OpenStack. That's why we are here, and OpenStack. The good news is that according to all the researches and according to our experience as well, OpenStack is more and more adopted in the whole industry. I took a quote from Forrester Research that OpenStack has grown into a de facto standard platform for private cloud, and I think it's a very good news for all of us. And if you take the production of OpenStack in the current IT environments, we can say that 71% of the deployments are in full production. So not just staging, not just testing, but real business usage. And I think that's very good news for all of us, and it will help us to be more successful, because if we know OpenStack good, we are familiar with this technology, then we will be successful in the future, because we can use this knowledge in our companies to do nice and interesting projects. And we at Suse do this as well. As I already mentioned, we started making products, making open source solution 25 years ago, and a couple of years ago we created our enterprise OpenStack solutions as well. Suse was the first company who created this enterprise version of OpenStack. It's called Suse OpenStack Cloud, and we think that the main advantage of a enterprise distribution is, like you can see on the slide, that OpenStack is a set of really nice tools and APIs, but with Suse OpenStack Cloud, we give you an easy to install and easy to manage and well integrated solution, just like buying a car instead of buying four wheels and the engine and widescreen and all these things to separately. So I think it's worth to take a distribution like Suse OpenStack Cloud if you want to deploy, if you want to use a OpenStack cloud solution. Why is it interesting, or why is it worth to use this kind of distribution? We are just at version 7, Suse OpenStack Cloud 7. It was released a couple of months ago, and it is based on the OpenStack Newton release, which is the last October OpenStack release. And actually, we try to combine the two important things. One is the traditional values, which are important for all the IT guys, all the operational guys, which means that we have to have a solution which is reliable, it has high availability, it's easy to manage, easy to operate, and build a reliable solution for the whole company. So that's why we create a business-oriented support lifecycle. It means that we release OpenStack Cloud versions rarely than the OpenStack project itself. We create just yearly one OpenStack Cloud release, and we give a longer support lifecycle, 2-3 years support lifecycle for each Suse OpenStack Cloud version. I think it's very important for a enterprise usage, and what is also important that we provide easy way to install and deploy the application with a nice crowbar interface. All the integration, all the deployment parts are integrated into this crowbar interface, and the OpenStack Cloud, Suse OpenStack Cloud version can be upgraded easily, so you don't have to reinstall and redeploy all the services. You can just simply upgrade version by version in the Suse OpenStack Cloud area. So that's one part, the traditional IT values, and the other part is supporting the new initiatives like DevOps, like Kubernetes, container technologies, new storage technologies, and all these important new features to support the companies be agile and be competitive in this new business environment. So containers and OpenStack, this is the topic of my presentation, and why we think it's important, why we think it's important to use containers, why there is such a high interest for containers today. Container is not a new technology. It is here for several years, both in the open source area, both in another operating system platforms. For instance, we support Linux containers for years in earlier version of Suse Linux Enterprise Server, and we have Docker support for about 2 years in Suse Linux Enterprise Server 12 version as well. So it's not new, and we have container technologies also on other operating system platforms, like we have desktop virtualization in Windows environment and things like that. So container technology is here in the market and here for several years now. But I think currently is the momentum to get it started. Why we think it's important. I think I can see two reasons for that. One is that we have several other technologies like Kubernetes, like the OpenStack support and things like that, which are developed and help the container technologies to easily install, easily manage, easily deploy. So that's one reason why this technology started widely used. And the other reason could be that container technology is very, very good for all these new DevOps initiatives, because it's very easy to deploy and manage applications, cloud-ready applications in this containerized environment. So I think that's the two reasons why container technology is a hot topic today, and more companies start using this container technology. What is exactly this container technology? It's a kind of lightweight virtualization. We do a virtualization on operating system level, not on hardware level, like in the traditional virtualization. And we don't think that container technology is an answer for everything. It is really good for new style cloud-ready applications, stateless applications, but it's not for everything, for every type of applications. I think in the future, in the near future, containerized applications and traditional applications will live together, and we will work with both of them. But and OpenStack, that is the reason why OpenStack is a very good solution to use supporting container technology, because OpenStack supports both kind of environments. There are some interesting numbers about the deployment of the container technologies that among the OpenStack users, 3 times faster the adoption rate of container technologies than in the rest of the users. And the containers and the Magnum technologies are the top projects currently in the OpenStack environment. How is it? How can we use containers in an OpenStack environment? There are two types of usage we can talk about. One is service containers, and the other ones are application containers. Service containers could be that we run OpenStack services in a container, like a control plane could run in a container environment, and we can use the auto scaling and all these nice features of the OpenStack cloud. So if you need more resources, more power for an OpenStack component, it could be easily managed in a container environment. But the other type, the application container, is the traditional usage, when we create an environment for the developers to easily use their applications, easily deploy and easily manage their applications. And that's the other area where OpenStack Cloud could be a useful tool and help us to create the containerized environment. We have several customers, not really Hungary, but Italy, in other countries, where this customer deployed OpenStack just to help more easily manage container technologies or create a Kubernetes cluster, because with the Magnum interface, it's very easy to create a set of containers, a Kubernetes of containers, and much easier to install and deploy this environment than deploying this without a OpenStack cloud. So that's as you can see in the slide. With the Magnum interface and the Kubernetes support, we can create a set of cluster in OpenStack, and we can use containers in a very, very nice and easy way, and using the heat part of the OpenStack cloud, we can set up the resources according to the needs and automatically schedule new virtual machines if anything is needed. So I think that's so Kubernetes is if you want to use containers, if you want to use Kubernetes, then it's very good to. It's a very very good idea to use it inside OpenStack. Basically, there are these major advantages to use Kubernetes inside an OpenStack environment. The first one is the simplified deployment, as I already mentioned, much easier to install and much easier to set up than without a OpenStack environment. Shared infrastructure, you can use the containerized infrastructure together with standard virtual machines or bare metal installation, and the same infrastructure can be used to manage the different type of installation, the different type of environments. Multi-tenancy support, that's also an important feature. If you have different set of different group of developers and you want to provide a container environment for each group of developers, then you can provide a separate set of containers for each group, and they can work separately. And you can do this in a OpenStack environment, and you cannot do it without OpenStack currently. And the fourth one I can mention is scalability, because using the automation and the scalability features of OpenStack, you can automatically scale the container environment according to the real usage. So I think that's the current situation, and that's the current environment, how to use Kubernetes as a service and how to use Kubernetes in a OpenStack environment. And as a last slide, I like to talk a bit about our future and our vision. How can we see the next couple of years in this area? We can see two important points or two important visions. One is the software-defined infrastructure, and the other one is the cloud-ready applications. And we at Suse build a solid and complex infrastructure to support all the both initiative and providing solution which can help the companies to create a easily scalable software defined infrastructure on one hand and a nice business driven applications on the other hand. As you can see, in the middle of this software-defined infrastructure is the OpenStack Cloud. The OpenStack Cloud is a nice tool to manage all the different type of software-defined solutions, like the different virtualization platform, the storage environment. We have a self-based storage solution, which is called Suse Enterprise Storage, which provides block file and object storage for OpenStack Cloud users. Of course, we can support software-defined networking, and we add several nice management tools to manage the whole infrastructure. You can see some of the management tools on the left side. We have Suse Manager, which is a nice tool to manage all the distributions, all the operating system. We have OpenATIC, which is a nice tool to manage Suse Enterprise Storage, the self-based storage environment. We have configuration management tools like Zsolt and Crowbar for deploying the OpenStack cloud environment. So a full set of management tools are available to manage the software-defined infrastructure. And we just announced a couple of days ago a new product, which is I can refer in this to the previous presentation. It was about Monasca and the OpenStack cloud monitoring products and solution. We just released together with Fujitsu a Suse Linux OpenStack monitoring solution, which is based on the Monasca projects. And as far as I could hear, that it is not easy to install and set up a Monasca solution. And I don't have any experience yet with our new Monasca-based monitoring solution, but I assume that the main advantage of this solution is to have an integrated, easy to manage and easy to install OpenStack monitoring solution. So that's brand new, it's still not on the slide, but it will be an important monitoring solution in the near future as well. So that's one part of the vision. I mean, the software-defined infrastructure. And the other part of the vision is the cloud-ready applications, providing tools to help everyone to create new type of applications. And here, one important thing is the containerized environment. We will release a container as a service solution, which will include Kubernetes as a orchestration engine. It will include Zsolt for configuration management, and there will be a nice new operating system called MicroOS, which is a really small footprint operating system created from Suse Linux Enterprise Server, and an operating system which is fully optimized for containerized application. It's very small, very lightweight, easy to manage, easy to do the updates. You can do updates, rollbacks, very fast to start, very fast to reload. So it's a real optimized operating system just for containerized environments. So that will be one tool to support the microservices, the new cloud-ready applications, and the other one will be the Cloud Foundry solution, which is not ready yet, but we work on it. And Suse bought several technologies and developers from HPE to support our OpenStack and our infrastructure as a service and our platform as a service initiatives. And in part of this this transaction, many developers and many technology came to us, and we will create a Cloud Foundry version of Suse later this year. So this is our vision, and I think it is not just Suse vision, but I think the vision of a new IT environment which supports both the software-defined infrastructure as the infrastructure part and the cloud-ready application as the application part. So thank you very much. That's all I wanted to tell you. I hope you have heard some interesting topics. Thank you very much.
Questions?
I think it will be available on both. The product is not ready yet, but as far as I heard, it will be available both on bare metal and on virtual machines as well.
Then if it will run on bare metal, then will it run next to KVM also? Will you have a hybrid cloud which can run containers on virtual machines next to each other, or it will be a separate system, one for containers and one for virtual machines?
Tricky question. I have two more slides, sorry, I just missed. One of them is we have a booth over there, and I have some technical colleagues here, more technical colleagues as well, and we can discuss this. And there is another thing I wanted to mention, that we have a small promotion running. If you want to win some nice gifts, then you can go to this site, novel.hu/promo, just a small questionnaire, 4 questions. If you fill it, you can win some nice goodies. And we can talk about this in a couple of minutes. Thank you.